and you go up to New Hampshire and you see the people, and their biggest problem, the first thing they always tell me about is they have a tremendous heroin problem, tremendous. And it doesn't seem right because, you know, the beautiful trees and the beautiful, I mean, everything's beautiful. It's like a beautiful place.
Heroin addiction's so powerful that we use no matter what. You threaten me, I'm going to prison, I'm still using. You want to take my kids? I'm still using. Family's going to turn their back on me, I'm still using. Going to be homeless, I'm still using. None of it matters.
From what I've heard from the DEA, they've considered this like ground zero. We're number one when it comes to fentanyl overdoses in the country. We're number two when it comes to opioid overdoses.
I've been sober since December 7th of 2006. I'd like to share some of my personal experience with opiate addiction. The days of heroin being an inner city stereotype fitting drug and culture are over.
From the outside, I did not look like the girl buying bags of heroin.
911 agent 127 with a request for police and ambulance. 31-year-old male, found not conscious, not breathing.
I never thought I was going to have a long life. I thought I was going to die. I thought I was going to go to prison for an incredibly long time.
Why can I sit in here and be okay and talk to you guys and share my story? I wish somebody had done that for me. If I just sat there and resigned myself to the fact that I'm a drug addict and there's no other way, then I would be among the dead, and I don't want that. And I don't want that for other people because there's too many people that don't care already.